The title of our paper, published in the Philippine Journal of Materials, Science, and Nanotechnology, Volume 7, Issue 1, July 2021 is Investigations on the Leaf Surface Ultrastructures in Hibiscus Stelaceous Lin, an Inspiration for Future Biomimetic Applications. Biomimetics harnesses nature-inspired principles and properties in the design and synthesis of advanced materials. The use of plants as biological models has provided the necessary stimulus for biomimicry. In this study, the abaxial and adaxial leaf surfaces of Hibiscus stelaceous Lin were investigated with respect to two parameters: ultrastructures and wetting behavior. Imaging techniques show that the abaxial side of the leaf consists of a dense network of non-glandular, simple, eight-arm stellate trichomes that are overlapping and intertwined. The adaxial side consists of the same type of trichomes, but with shorter stellate arms and sparsely arranged on the surface. Contact angle measurements show that the adaxial surface is hydrophilic, with a contact angle average of 71.71 degrees plus and minus 4.14 degrees, while the abaxial surface is nearly super hydrophobic at 142.98 degrees plus and minus 2.92 degrees. The effect of a homogeneous overlay of dense stellates on the abaxial surface and the height variations of nanostructures on these stellates result in a more effective overall roughness, which can explain the nearly super hydrophobic property exhibited by the bottom site. This is the first report in the surface morphology and wetting behavior of H. stelaceous. Data provided in this work will be useful in exploring future biomimetic potentials of this plant. There is a need for innovative approaches using lessons we learned from nature to solve challenging real-world problems. Biological systems such as plants are interesting models for this purpose. However, a thorough understanding of the plant surface structures, chemical compositions, and wetting behavior is necessary to design and create products with unique biomimetic applications. The development and synthesis of advanced materials are now largely inspired by different biological systems that surround us. Biomimicry takes inspiration from nature and unleashes the next wave of innovative discoveries that solve complex problems in many disciplines. It is also considered an exciting route in science and engineering for the creation of functional products that are also sustainable and environmentally sound. Hence, the use of biomimetic approaches provides a reliable direction to product design because they take advantage of the unique and diverse properties exhibited by model living organisms. Modern products, say those with anti-drag, self-cleaning, and water-repelling characteristics, sensory feedback or defense aspects, and energy-producing capabilities, just to name a few, all have biomimicry footprints. Plants are excellent models in biomimicry. Plant functions are largely dependent on structures present on the surface of the plant part, therefore making the study of the epidermal layers as important as the study of the properties itself. The heterogeneity of plant surfaces is due to variations in cell shapes, the formation of multicellular structures, the presence of micro and nanostructures, as well as the diversity of its chemical compositions. The outermost layers of plant leaves generally include epithelial waxes, wax crystals, surface foldings in some, and glandular and non-glandular, unicellular and multicellular trichomes. Combined, all these form multistructural and multifunctional boundary layers between the plant and its surroundings. Earlier studies on plant surfaces focused mainly on identifying the type of trichomes present. Recently, these leaf surface structures are also found to be associated with plant properties. For example, more studies have shown the direct link between chemical composition and hierarchical complexity of plant surface structures, as well as observed properties such as surface roughness, oleophilicity, oleophobicity, hydrophilicity, and hydrophobicity are just some of the most popular plant leaf characteristics that are usually explored to fully understand potential biomimetic applications. Many water-repellent plants have already been studied, and the observed hydrophobicity was attributed to the presence of micro and nanostructures on the leaf surfaces. Recently, fresh leaves of the floating fern, Salvinia molesta, have been reported to be both super hydrophobic and super hydrophilic, the Salvinia paradox. And this is attributed to the plant's unique and sophisticated egg beater-shaped trichomes. Hibiscus tiliaceous Linn of the family Malvaceae, commonly called sea hibiscus or coast cottonwood, is a typical coastal plant of the tropics and subtropics. It may be found in several regions, including East Africa, South and Southeast Asia, North and East Australia, and West in the Central Pacific Ocean Islands, and is also classified as an invasive species. H. tiliaceous is found throughout the Philippines, where it is popularly known as malubago or balibago. It is a fast-growing evergreen tree reaching as much as 10 meters in height when mature, with a broad crown of widely spreading and crooked branches that form dense thickets. The mature leaf is leathery, hairy on the abaxial side, and has a blade that is 10 to 18 centimeters in length, nearly smooth in margin, suborbicular in morphology with a pointed apex and a heart-shaped base, and forms an alternate arrangement along the stem. The leaves are usually dark green, but there are sections of the same tree exhibiting variegation. The five-petaled flower is bell-shaped, about 10 to 15 centimeters wide when fully open, bright yellow in color, and usually with a dark red eye spot inside. As reported in various papers presented in literature, the ability of plant leaf surfaces to exhibit a wide array of unique characteristics may be partly attributed to the nature of its structures. There has been growing interest to better correlate the plant leaf surface topography and the resulting properties. Studies in this area are important as they can provide a better understanding of the potential biomimetic applications of plants. It is the aim of this work to study Hibiscus tiliaceous Linn for this purpose. Previous data from our work already revealed a promising application based on the measured high sorption capacity, 1.7693 plus and minus 0.0793 grams per oil adsorbed per gram sorbent of the plant's leaf. And this provided an inspiration to study other aspects of the plant leaf. In this paper, the wettability properties of H. tiliaceous will be explored. To date, This is the first preliminary report describing the wetting behavior of H. tiliaceus. It is hypothesized in this work that the wettability of the H. tiliaceus leaf can be correlated to the leaf surface roughness or topography, as initially revealed by imaging data. Pertinent data from the study may be able to provide a strong basis for future considerations of H. tiliaceus as a potential sustainable material for relevant biomimetic applications. For example, plant-based bioremediation or water-repellent materials. The list shown here summarizes the methodologies used in the study. Briefly, hibiscus tiliaceous lin leaves were collected from De La Salle University Laguna Campus, Binian, Laguna, Philippines. The collected stems were initially air-dried for 4 hours or until no visible moisture was evident. For each stem, starting from the terminal bud, leaves at the third node and farther down were used as they were considered mature and fully expanded. To examine the structures of the adaxial, the top, and the abaxial or bottom surfaces of freshly collected H. tiliaceous leaves, 3 imaging techniques were used. 1, digital microscopy. 2, scanning electron microscopy. And 3, atomic force microscopy. Finally, the contact angle was measured using an optical tensiometer with a water droplet volume of 5 microliters. Appropriate statistical analysis were conducted. The next slide shows the results of the study. H. tiliaceous leaves were initially observed using digital microscopy. This preliminary examination revealed differences between the abaxial and adaxial surfaces of the leaves, as shown. Figure 1 reveals the presence of starfish-shaped structures on both the abaxial and adaxial leaf surfaces of H. tiliaceus. These structures are characteristics of stellate trichomes. In general, trichomes are simply epidermal cells that have a drawn-out cuticle, forming hair-like structures referred to as plant hairs. A stellate trichome is described as multicellular, consisting of a central base with attached hair-like extensions called arms or rays projecting from it. The number of stellate arms is typically at least 3. The digital images of H. tiliaceus revealed the presence of non-glandular, simple, 8-arm stellate trichomes on both the abaxial and adaxial leaf surfaces of H. tiliaceus. To better describe the trichomes, the abaxial and adaxial sides of the leaves were examined under the scanning electron microscope, and this is shown next. Stem images of H. tiliaceous leaves reveal more details on the stellate trichomes on the abaxial and adaxial surfaces. The abaxial surface consists of non-glandular, simple, 8-arm stellates. The arms appear long and tapering and pointed at the tip of nearly equal length, around 100 to 150 micrometers, each based on the scale bar. Nearly erect and not oppressed to the leaf stamina. It is also remarkable from the images that the trichomes are superimposed on one another, forming a dense mass of overlapping stellates that almost completely cover the underlying epidermal cells and stomata. The network of stellates also shows that the trichome arms appear intertwined. The adaxial side of H. tiliaceus also shows non-glandular, simple, 8-arm stellate trichomes. However, unlike the stellates observed on the abaxial surface, they appear short in length, less than 100 micrometers, each base also on the scale bar, oppressed more to the lamina and only sparsely covering the surface. To further investigate and compare the leaf structures of H. tiliaceus lin, the samples were examined under the atomic force microscope and is shown next. Figure 3 in this slide compares the stellate arms from the abaxial and adaxial surfaces as analyzed by the AFM. Figures 3A and 3B are optical images of the stellate arms. They show the actual physical structures that were examined under the AFM. Figures 3C and 3D, which show the face images of the plant surfaces, may be directly associated with the actual topography of the surfaces, since these images result from how the cantilever tip interacts with the structures present on the scanned surfaces. Hence, the surface irregularities, the peaks and the valleys seen in the face images can be interpreted as evidence that the stellate arms from both the abaxial and adaxial sides exhibit roughness. The valleys correspond to higher angles, as shown by lightly colored areas in the face image. The variation in color shows a difference in material properties. Micrographs of 2D and 3D height, as seen in E, F, G, and H, confirm the presence of nanostructures of varying minima and maxima, as seen in the color scale. The light color representing asperity and the dark color representing depression. The section analysis plots, I and J, further prove this height variation by clearly showing the valleys at lower than negative 400 nanometers and peaks at around positive 400 nanometers for both surfaces. Note, however, that based on the height density versus nanostructure height plots, as shown in figure 4 here, both the abaxial and adaxial surfaces of hibiscus ciliaceus lin exhibit roughness, but of different degrees. The abaxial side exhibited a frequency distribution peak of 0.862% for nanostructure height 0.354 micrometers asperity, while the adaxial side exhibited a frequency distribution peak of 1.674% for height 0.32 micrometers, also asperity. Likewise, looking at the general trend from the same plot for heights 500 nanometers and below, the distribution in the adaxial surface is at most times higher. A higher frequency distribution in a greater variation in nanostructure height imply that the stellate arm in the adaxial side of H. ciliaceus has a more irregular topography than the abaxial side. To validate the observations and data presented above, a plot of the log unit PSD per nanometer to the fourth versus frequency is shown in figure 5. Comparing the topography of a defined scanned area on the stellate arms on the abaxial and adaxial surfaces of the leaf, the power spectral density, or PSD, of a signal describes the power present in that signal as a function of frequency per unit frequency. Therefore, PSD gives the strength of the variations as a function of frequency. On the other hand, the log represents the amplitude or maximum displacement from a reference axis of a surface's roughness as a function of spatial frequency, which is the inverse of the wavelength of the roughness features. Hence, this type of plot is also useful in evaluating surface topography because amplitude may be correlated to roughness. On both surfaces, low amplitude peaks are more frequent per specified distance, implying that the surfaces are mostly covered by shorter nanostructures. At lower spatial frequency, the two graphs appear to converge. The difference between the two surfaces becomes more evident at around 3 per micrometer mark. The two profiles have a large flat region starting at this mark, indicating high lateral roughness on both sides of the leaf. Based on the general trend seen from the plot, the adaxial surface is rougher than the abaxial surface because of the higher log values for each frequency data point. Therefore, this supports a discussion above explaining the height density versus nanostructure height plot. Table 1 presents a summary of the roughness parameters comparing the stellate trichome arm on the abaxial and adaxial surfaces of fresh H. tiliaceous leaves. This comparison is relevant as this will provide information on how any differences in the wetting behaviors between the top and bottom sides of the leaf can be explained by variations in the surface roughness or topography, resulting from the presence of micro and nano structures. Roughness parameter values are consistently larger for the adaxial stellate arm as compared to the abaxial stellate arm. In order to determine the wetting behavior of H. tiliaceous and to fully understand the effect of leaf structures present on the abaxial and adaxial surfaces of the plant, contact angles were measured. Representative images showing the water droplets on the abaxial and adaxial leaf surfaces are shown on this slide. The adaxial surface, which gave a mean contact angle value of 71.71 degrees, plus and minus 4.14 degrees, with N equal to 6, is considered as hydrophilic, contact angle being less than 90 degrees. On the other hand, the abaxial surface, which gave a mean contact angle of 142.98 degrees, plus and minus 2.92, N equal to 12, may be classified as either hydrophobic, based on the more traditional classification, or nearly super hydrophobic based on the more accurate measurement of wetting and adhesion interactions published by law in 2014, which defines super hydrophobicity for when the contact angle is greater than 145 degrees. The abaxial and adaxial surfaces of H. tiliaceous leaves have non-glandular, simple, eight-arm stellate trichomes. The abaxial side has a dense network of overlapping, intertwined, and longer stellates, while the adaxial side shows fewer and shorter stellates. Wettability studies show that the adaxial surface is hydrophilic, 7.71 degrees plus and minus 4.14 degrees for its contact angle, while the abaxial surface is nearly super hydrophobic, getting an average contact angle of 142.98 degrees plus and minus 2.92 degrees based on the studies by law. The AFM images and plots of height density versus nanostructure height and log versus frequency show greater variation in nanostructure height for the adaxial surface. Combined data indicate that while roughness is higher on the adaxial surface, stellates distribution is sparse. On the other hand, the effect of a homogeneous overlay of dense stellates on the abaxial side and height variation of nanostructures on these stellates result in more effective overall roughness of this surface. And this influenced wetting behavior, leading to a nearly super hydrophobic property. The data then imply that for a plant to be water repellent, not only is trichome type and roughness important, but the trichome coverage as well. The results obtained from the study of the leaf nanostructures in H. tiliaceous Linn provide valuable information on how leaf morphology can be explored in future biomimetic applications, in particular in the design of uniquely functional water-repellent materials and in the development of innovative bioremediation technologies. This is the first report on H. tiliaceous in the areas of surface morphology and wettability. We would like to acknowledge the De La Salle University Research Coordination Office, the DLSU Science Foundation, Ms. Gabito and Ms. Salas for some contact angle measurements. And here are some selected references.